They say, you know, no man is an island, and maybe I thought I was going to be my own island, but I was very much linked to the mainland, to my past. I'm Mark Whitaker. I'm the managing editor of CNN Worldwide. Both of my parents became academics. My father, when they first met, was an undergraduate, a student at Swarthmore, and they started what had to be a secret romance because he was a black student, she was a white teacher. The period in Los Angeles, as my parents' marriage was breaking up, I just have sort of fleeting memories of that. My mother had given up her tenured job at Swarthmore to follow my father, but he had already been carrying on a number of affairs. The divorce happened and we had to move with my mother back to the East Coast. I started eating compulsively. I ultimately became almost 100 pounds overweight by the time I entered my teens. I think what got me through it was that ability to sort of remove myself from the circumstances. Despite all the unhappiness of my childhood, one thing I'm very grateful for is that my mother always insisted that we have a good education. I ended up leaving Swarthmore after a semester, and I was again lucky enough to get another scholarship to go to Harvard. There were two things that I think changed my life. One was when I walked into the college newspaper. I immediately felt like this is it, this is my home. The other thing was meeting my wife. I sort of instantly sensed that she was someone who I could have a very different relationship with than I had seen with my father and my mother and some of the other women he had been involved with. One of the things that about my father, you know, who was in some ways a very troubled man, but also a very brilliant man. He, throughout my very sort of turbulent relationship with him, was always sort of coming up with these expressions. And one of them was what he told me when I was graduating from Harvard. And he said, well, just remember, beware of what you want because you might get it. It was sort of a mini aha moment when he first told me, but as I went back and I remembered that and I put it in the context of what happened to me as an adult, it was a very big aha moment. And I'm grateful for my father, you know, trying to sort of, you know, in his own way, teach me some of the larger lessons of life.